Low, by Charles Hoyfort, Part 3, Chapter 24d, the 16th of August, 1906, and suddenly people living along the road to Valparaiso, Chile, lost sight of the city. There had come a terrible darkness. With it came an earthquake, the splitting of ground, and the roar of falling houses, intensest darkness, and then a voice in this chaos. It was a scream. People along the road heard it approaching. Chile lit up. Under a flaming sky, the people of Valparaiso were running from the smashing city, people as red as flames under the glare in the heavens, screaming and falling and leaping over the bodies of the fallen, an eruption of spurting forms that leapt and were extinguished. This reddened gush from Valparaiso, rising, falling shapes, brief faces and momentary arms, it was like looking at vast flames and imagining that spurts of them were really living beings. In Nature, Volume 50, page 990, it is said the 136 reports upon illuminations in the sky at Valparaiso had been examined by County Ballor, the seismologist. At one stroke, he bobbed 98 of them, saying that they were indefinite. He said that the remaining 38 reports were more or less explicit, but came from a region where at the time, a deluge was falling. He clipped these, too. For a wonder there was an objection. A writer in Scientific American, Volume 107, page 67, pointed out that de Ballor so dismissed the subject, without inquiring into the possibility that the quake and the deluge were related. Had he admitted the possibility of relationship, dogma would have slipped upon dogma, and upon the face of this earth there would have been a subsidence of some ignorance. The lights that were seen in the sky, said de Ballor, were very likely only searchlights from warships. The whole sky seemed afire, Scientific American, Volume 106, page 464. In Simmons, Meteorological Magazine, Volume 41, page 226, William Gough of Santiago, describing the blazing heavens, writes that it seemed as if the sober laws of physics had revolted. Or, said de Ballor, the people may have seen lights from tram cars. It does not matter how preposterous some of my own notions are going to seem. They cannot be more out of accordance with events upon this earth than is such an attribution of the blazing sky of a nation to searchlights or to lamps in dram cars. If I should write that the stars are probably between 40 and 50 miles away, I'd be not much more of a trimmer of circumstances than is such a barber, who clips are said to be scientific. Maybe they are scientific, though, mostly, barbers are artists, some of them do consider themselves scientific.